this is an operating system, free software, running on GNU Linux, and it's one of the things we develop here in the Art Lab. It's called Dynabolic. It works on old computers and is done for activating old computers in use for production of media art and also for free speech. You can do a radio with it, you can cut videos, and it's completely free. It's free to be copied, redistributed, modified under the GNU General Public License. We use this operating system also in workshops, for instance, recently in the radio workshop. And we give also a copy to everyone.
And behind it, there is the idea that free software should be there to provide people tools for communication. The concern about developing this software is very political. It's about keeping a democratic platform where that people that really need to say something will always have at hand in order to say something. To make a radio station, to give voice to your community, to the problems that you face in your life, or also to the advantages that your community has, or whatever. Another point that is very important: the free software license says that you can modify and redistribute any modification. So the CD I'm giving you, it says also like it's unauthorized copying, redistribution is encouraged. You can do whatever you want with it. There is also a compiler on it. There are all the tools that I used to maintain and pack this software. I didn't wrote all the software. It's a collective work of a lot of people. I'm basically a maintainer, let's say a person that put together all this and writes the software, the operating system behavior together. So I could, on my own, take other people's production and put it inside this and redistribute it. And you can also sell it. You can sell this very CD that I gave you. It's completely legal to sell it. You can do really whatever you want. So, how it works? You basically, you can have a computer with any operating system on. I'm not sure what is already on those. There can be Windows also. You don't really care about that because you can always go back. There is no installation. It's a live CD. It can run faster if you copy a directory on the hard disk. It's just copying a directory. That's the only installation, which we call doc. Well, what you can do is just press record and grab the microphone and speak into it. And you will see that it... no, the microphone is...
Probando.
You can click now in different points and drag around.
Oh.
And try a different point. Yeah.
Okay. Oh yeah.
It's a whole radio production course, so you have to imagine this. You start with recording things around, like you can go around with mobile phone and record interviews. Then you come back home and you. Put them inside such a program, you put some music already, so you prepare already, and then you start a live stream, where of course you can talk live inside, but then you also play the footage that you prepare. So if you follow this flow, you don't need many tools, you with a cheap computer you can actually produce a professional radio program. Right?
Okay.
And it is done to stream. To stream audio to an antenna so that people can listen to it. So the stream goes like this. You have one source and you will send it to a big antenna, which is a server in a data center. And this server will send it back to people.
So this is a website online that lists right away all the streams that are active.
Oh.
You can go down and look if yours is also listed. Yes, that's you.
And now consider that this is a simple list, but it's we also announce it to other directories. So people listening on radios, even like on internet radios that are really built in China, they can find you somehow. And this system is the Sync Starter that was developed here in Nimca in the last 4 years. It's a free software as well. To sync start, to synchronize the playback of videos. Here we can see an installation by Kalindan,
That was one of the first video, things started the video art pieces that were run on this system. And this box was the first prototype of the system. And with the two video cards, it can play back already two channels. Now here what we have is another computer with four cards playing back this video. And this is one of the computers that we had in the house since more than 4 years. So basically we reused all the computers, even if old, to play back installations. So the software was developed in-house and it's redistributed freely, so anyone can adopt it also to make installations, video installations.